Welcome to the NPS channel, students. Here, today I'm going to start the archaeological structure and features of the urban civilization. In this part 2, we will get the total civilization town planning. But before this, we have to recapitulation our previous knowledge. Like in our previous video, we have talked about what does civilization mean, some features of civilizations, and Indus Valley civilization, which is an urban civilization, and we have talked about that particular sightings which have been found through the excavation. And we have also discussed through the map portion. Now for today, we have to discuss from here architectural features of the urban civilization. Early urban civilization displayed impressive achievements in planning, technological advancement, and engineering. Imagination, let's discuss is in it detail. Okay, so what is town planning here? In early cities, the Harappan civilization were well-planned city. So the streets cut each other at right cities of Harappa civilization, right angles, and it consisted of granaries. Now what is granary? Granaries? In that particularly timing or era, people used to store their grains for seasonal wise to make granaries. In Mohenjo-daro, the main street had houses built on both of the sides with baked brick. Now what is baked brick? It is kind of a preformation of burnt brick nowadays, which we are using for our homemaking purpose, and baked brick look like a scarlet color. This street was 800 meter long and 10 meter wide, so you can imagine how wide it is. And the main feature was that the city was divided into two parts. One part was built on raised ground and had a protective wall which gave protection during the floods and any other kinds of extra calamities, natural calamities even happen in that era. So in that times, particularly from that types of imagination, they built it. The other part was the lower town. It consisted with wide wall roads. The town were managed with proper administration. So you can see it from here. If I'm zooming it, then you can see clearly the citadel portion, which is kind of upper portion of the Harappa civilization area, as well as some excavated sites or areas been found. And if you look around in the right hand section's image, this is the main Harappa city. This area represents citadel, and this is the other kinds of excavated area, and this pink side is represent the main roads, which is kind of main street, 8 meters long and 10 meters wide. Okay, now if we move around to for knowing few things like what is citadel, what is acropolis, and we have been found from here, the most of the cities were divided into two parts. The upper parts was called citadel, and the most buildings such as palace of the ruler, homes of the ruling class, public halls, religious structure, and granaries were constructed on citadel. It was also called as acropolis. I want to show you here what is basically its look like. Just have a look. This part, this area basically represent the citadel area. Okay, and this area, this lower region, basically low town area, which basically peasants, craftsmen, fishermen, and agricultural workers, and any other kinds of status-wise and wages-wise low worker, they are used. The lower town area, and the citadel, basically we already knew that this part totally consisted for the higher class people. Okay, this was also known as Acropolis as well. So here, one thing already kind of, I think, in your mind, like, why granaries then consisted or constructed on citadel? Like, we already knew that in that time of era, agricultural worker as well, they are made some types of food from the agricultural work, and they have to pay taxes. Like many types of taxes in that time, they have to pay crop taxes as well. So for the seasonal conversation purpose and for the seasonal archive purpose, a ruler also made some rule in Harappa civilization that they have to made a proper granary, and for the whole civilization sake of population, they have to store it for that area. For this kinds of things, they have to get paid by the ruler or the palace person on that era. Okay, so they are, that's why we can say the administrative people also did that types of thing. They constructed for their own conception, they constructed granaries on that side. I want to show you here what does granaries look like. This is granary. Okay, look, basically in Harappan site, like we are already knew that there are so many ancient civilization in world, like Mesopotamian civilization, Maya civilization, Babylon civilization, Harappan civilization, and it's part of Mohenjo-daro civilization. But if I'm talking about few civilization choose for their granaries rectangular shape, and few are chosen in particular that timing circular shaped. Okay, so if you look at into that debris, okay, that debris in that particularly area, they consisted in that time archive the grains for the seasonal consumption wise. Okay, now have a look, the famous debris from the Mohenjo-daro sighting, which is the Great Bath. Now, what is Great Bath? The Great Bath of Mohenjo-daro was like a public place and was constructed on a citadel. It was made of burnt brick. Now, this is the proper brick which we are using nowadays for our homemaking purpose, and which we are coated with the plaster to making, and may for waterproof purpose, and coating with a tar also applied to prevent any kind of seepage and sewage. Okay, and it had means they are kind of did waterproof thing. Okay, and it had a flight of steps either side of a head. The floor of the bath was also made of burnt bricks. It had several rooms which were probably used for changing clothes, wet clothes also, and bathing purpose. The structure shows that it was meant for the religious and the ritual bathing. They basically used for the ritual bathing. Okay, I want to show you the picture. This is the Great Bath. This place represents the Great Bath. Okay, when kind of any persons on that particular area or king's sons crowned by birth privilege, okay, they types of do in that time they did the ritual bath thing. Okay, so that's why this place is very famous. And in Mohenjo-daro, which is the Pakistan side also, which is was first excavated side, this Great Bath is famous for in that. Okay, now move on to the other part of the lower town where small houses of common people were built. Some houses were one store and other had two story. Houses also had courtyard with rooms in them, and they also had bathrooms, kitchen, and even wells. Like we already knew that on that type of moment, in that type of era, few peoples basically used to believe they kind of doing vastu thing or vastu dasha, vastu rituals. They are just like thinking on that if we are kind of using wells in our home or making wells, it would be good for our home, for our vastu. So in that they are making wells, and like our nowadays they have kitchen, like we have this, bathrooms as well. And houses also have courtyard with rooms in them. Now, basically, we have also courtyard right now in a few of our places and few of our homes. Basically, we used in a garage purpose. Some people's also making some gardening things. And on that time, they basically kind of domesticated animal purpose. They use that area and do some gardening thing. And they also kind of archive their seasonal grain. Okay, that purpose they are used. And we have seen that one storied building are also there and two storied buildings are also there nowadays, like they are also used to do that. Okay, now move on to huge halls, altars and granaries. Now what is huge halls? Huge halls are look like assembly hall, meeting palaces and granaries. We have already seen that in a picture that stored grains were discovered in cities like Harappa and Mohenjo-daro sites. And these granaries consisted of circular brick pattern, like you have seen here, in a rectangular pattern, right? So basically this comes from other civilization, like somehow Mohenjo-daro civilization also, they are kind of using that particular types, they made that types of granary. But Harappa civilization, they used to make kind of round shape or circular pattern granary. Okay, they basically use circular pattern granary. And this sites also found in many places. Now, what is altars? Here, the altars where the sacrifice or the other rituals were probably performed have been found in Kalibangan and Lothal. We have already knew that this too is a famous sites. Lothal is in right now in India and Kalibangan right now in a Pakistan sites. Right. So, have a look. What is the altars look like? I want to show you here. Like, have you seen this? This area basically represent altars on that time of when king got crowned or any king particularly murdered his rival, or any types of sacrifices from the rituals done here after they take ritual bath from here. Got it? Hope you will understand. And from this part, the lower town was situated outside the citadel. It was arranged in block of rectangular shape with a wide road and effective drainage systems in there. Craftsmen and merchants or labor resides in this part. I want to show you this part again. This rectangular shape area, and you can see the street, this straight street, and few streets are also in there, cut off that places, okay, angle wise also in there. So this total part, not this fort area, this total lower part region, basically craftsmen, agricultural worker, any other kinds of labor resides there. This area totally for them, okay. And they have good type of drainage system. Now, what is drain and streets? Drainage systems and layout of streets were another outstanding features of Harappa civilization. Like nowadays wise, the drains in the cities covered with laid off straight lines, and they were built with slopes so that the water could flow easily. Houses drains were connected to the main streets and drains. They were covered with the slabs and Manholes were made equal intervals to clean them on regular basis. I want to show you one things from here. So you can see that this specifically this area, you can see the one slabs is there. Under of this debris, you will find the channel of main drainage. So they are making kind of gradient wise their slope, so the city would clean on that time. And their homes wastage materials also connect to their home drains, to the that main drains, so the cities also and their homes get cleared. Okay, and as well as in an interval wise long section area or long sections of road, they have proper manhole nowadays like we have. So I think up to that it's you have got the clear idea. So basically from part 2 we have got the idea about the town planning things, architectural features an urban civilization had, the town planning, what their streets look like. We have seen in that map also what is citadel, what is the great bath, why should we call the citadel acropolis, also which purpose in that time great bath used, right? And what is huge halls and altars on that time using, the systems of lower town as well as the drainage and street pattern. And we have seen here and we have got the total portion about this great bath pictures, granary as well as citadel. And this, we can say this is also one type of altar. Okay, this is rituals are also doing in that place. I think hope you like the session. Next sessions I will start from the other part. Till then, take care, see you soon. Thank you.